without research and without the knowledge of things that are possible, we wouldn't be here today. We didn't know 10 years ago that CAR T therapy was possible. Our next step would have been bone marrow transplant. Having the research and getting to a place where we had a different option, we didn't have to do that, is huge. My name's Adrienne Horn. My daughter is Lianna Munir. We are from New Jersey. She's very, very outgoing, definitely has a huge personality. I couldn't force her to come in the house after school or sit down or not do anything, and all of a sudden she just started slowing down a lot. She had come home from school, she was very, very tired, and I was putting her in the shower, and my husband was in the other room, and she just kind of looked at me, and her eyes kind of went right past me, and she just passed out. And I ripped her out of the tub and put her on the bathroom floor, and my husband came running in, and we rushed her to Virtua and Voorhees. Spent the whole night there doing blood work and things like that. They gave her fluids and stuff. A couple days later, same thing happened. She passed out again. We went back. Then they medically transported us to CHOP. We were doing a bunch of testing, and then five doctors walked in and said, we believe it's leukemia.
Your life changes completely upside down in a matter of seconds. You ask for a lot of help from the hospital, from family, from everybody, sorry.
You're not prepared for one second. You're home and you have school and you're doing all these things, the next second, you know, I can't go to work. I have to live at the hospital. Life doesn't stop because your daughter has cancer. As her mother, I said, there's no way that I'm walking out of this hospital even to go outside and get a breath of fresh air in 8 months. Like, that's just not gonna happen. So my husband, you know, had to step up, and he's going to work at 4 o'clock in the morning and working and then coming straight to the hospital and then sleeping in a cot next to us and then leaving to go home and let the dogs out, make sure the bills are all paid. It's all just balance, and it's really, really hard. We went right in and we started treatments from there, starting intense chemotherapy. She had a lot of complications because she also has a different type of leukemia, which is a little bit harder. It's called like the Philadelphia ALL leukemia, PAX5, JAK2. When the third month came around, she still had 75.8% of leukemia still left in her bone marrow. So we were really nervous. And at that point is when Dr. Rangold and the CAR-T people stepped in and said, you know, we have a very small window of opportunity here before she gets very sick and before the chemotherapy starts killing off cells.
13 years ago, we gave the very first patient in the United States and the world CAR-T cell therapy, which is an immune therapy whereby we take T cells, one of the immune cells, out of patients, outside of the body. We genetically manipulate it so that instead of going back in and attacking things like viruses, it attacks the child's leukemia cells. And it has been revolutionary in those 13 years.
She has zero detectable leukemia in her B cells right now from the CAR-T therapy. We just take it day by day, but definitely the CAR-T therapy has been less invasive and hurtful inside her body. We need the funding to keep moving forward, to keep getting to a place where you don't only have that one option. It was the information, the funding, the backing that said, okay, well, this didn't work, we can try this. Let's try this, and when this doesn't work, guess what? We're on plan B right now. We haven't gotten to plan D yet. But the fact that we're at a place where we even have a plan D and you don't have to stop at plan B is the research.
She's doing fantastic. She has, you know, no evidence of disease recurrence.
I feel not scared anymore, and I feel a little happier.